Do you know that when setting up Windows XP, the quick format option actually doesn't do anything bad and saves you a heck of a lot of time on modern drives? I'm Dan Afonso from Afonso Consulting and Enfold IT, and this is how to install Windows XP. Now, I'm just going to tell you straight out, this is a fairly straightforward process. If you've got standard hardware, any consumer hardware really, it's not really going to be a problem for you. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through the installation. I'm doing it in VMware because bringing in additional hardware to do this is actually kind of difficult. So we're just going to do this in virtual. The only difference between this and what you're going to do is there's no CD switching. So I've already put the CD in the drive, and we're going to start up the machine. Now, the first thing you're going to notice is, besides the machine booting, is that it's going to pause here and say that it's loading Windows. If you already had an operating system on the machine, it would ask you to push a button in order to boot. It's also asking you to push F2 for automated system recovery and F6 for additional drivers. Automated system recovery is if you break your machine and have an automated system recovery disk. The F6 is far more important to this. If you have an obscure RAID driver, if you have some sort of RAID 0 for your hyper gaming machine, you're probably going to need to hit F6 and pop in the floppy disk. Yes, a floppy disk. If you don't want to make a floppy disk, you'll have to make a custom boot CD for Windows XP. We're not going to cover that here. We're just going to move on. The first thing Windows is going to do is it's going to initialize itself. This is an informational screen, lets you know if you want to repair, set up, or whatnot. In this case, we're just going to set up, so we're hitting enter. The end user license agreement, you have to accept it in order to continue on. Now, this is the disk partitioning portion. If you want to use the whole drive for the C drive, and I highly recommend you do this, unless you're going to dual boot or have some sort of other partitioning scheme in mind, just hit enter and it'll use a default. If you need to partition, what you would do is you would push C. It's for create partition. And then you could type in how much you want and make multiple partitions and whatnot, then select them from the list. So from this case, sure, we'll make a 7 gig partition, and then I'll create another partition over here just to show you. In general, there's really no need to do this. So we'll create this and we'll use the quick format NTFS because this is significantly better. It's going to format now. So once it's done copying all those files, it's going to reboot the machine into the graphical portion. All right, so after a good long while, you're going to get to the regional language options screen. If you need to change your language, your input method, or anything like that, you can customize that. But for most people, this is going to be the normal. Just hit next. Type in your name and your organization. Hit next. Now you're going to give your product key. For obvious reasons, I'm not going to type in mine on camera, but we'll just type that in and go to the next screen. All right, the next screen, you get to name your machine. I'm going to name mine Bob. Bob's a good name. And you can set your administrator password. Anything you want, you should probably make this something reasonably secure, like not password. Your next screen just wants to know date, time, and most importantly, the time zone. Now, you don't really have to set the date and time here. It can figure that out once it connects up to the internet. But your time zone is important. So set that, hit next. Here on in, it's going to configure your network. It's going to ask you whether you want to do this customized, default. Well, you just pick typical. It'll get you going for now. If you need to change something, you can do that later. Most people won't need to change anything. And finally, your work group. If you have set up a work group in-house, feel free to use it. If you haven't, the default is fine. And from here on in, it's just going to finish the installation. Once it comes up, all you really need to do is run Windows Update. It'll start doing this in the background automatically. Let her finish. You should be all set from there. This has been How to Install Windows XP. I'm Dan Afonso of Enfold IT and Afonso Consulting. Enjoy.